Hello, everybody. This week, just going to have a little sit down, and it's my birthday week. We're going to discuss some movies starting right now. Like I said in that short little intro, I have my birthday happening, and so we decided to go see The Hobbit, The Battle of the Five Armies, and I want to give a little bit of a review for that movie. Personally, it was great. I loved it, but we'll get into more of that in a second. Also, there's a new trailer for the new Star Wars movie that's going to come out this time next year, which I want to give my thoughts on the trailer as well. But first, let's stick with the Hobbit movie. And I guess I would say, overall, like I said, I thought the movie itself was great. I thought the movie was... It turned itself back to Lord of the Rings, because I liked the first movie, The Unexpected Journey. I liked how, you know, it started out. I know a lot of people criticized it, but personally, I really didn't have a problem with it. The second movie, though, The Desolation of Smaug, that I thought was a little bit stretchy. There were some things that were a little over cheesy, and it was probably my least favorite Middle-earth movie that I have seen. But that goes without saying, I still enjoyed it. And so my expectations were a little bit lower when it came to watching this initial movie, Battle of the Five Armies, but totally blew away my expectations. I was loving every minute. I didn't want it to end. And this is the first time for the Hobbit trilogy, that I look forward to getting the extended edition to watch all the extra scenes. And this movie really tied in the other movies really well, towards like, you really need to watch all three in order to understand everything. And I'm probably going to resort back to that when it comes to, like, I do have a couple of critiques, and I'll probably have to come back to that when it comes to critiquing. But the pros of the movie, like I say, there were awesome fight scenes. The initial, and caution, before I say anything else, there will be spoilers. So if you haven't watched the movie, go see it, and then come back and listen to me. The first few minutes of the movie, when you have Smaug completely destroying Lake Town, that was great. I like how they did that. And then initially, the movie really just keeps on a good pace throughout the whole time until you finally get to the Five Armies battle. So good pacing. I loved, especially at the end, when Bilbo returns home. And this is in the books. This is in the storyline, to where they're basically auctioning off his house and all his house items. So he's got to stop his hobbit friends from doing that. I thought, like, yes, yeah, I so wanted to see that. So, and I look forward to the extended version, which hopefully we'll see more of, like, the dwarfs going on their thing, Balin going to Moria, trying to reestablish Moria, and end up failing. I hope we see a little bit of that, as well as maybe a pre-Gimli or Legolas joining the Rangers more. And stuff like that. But it's just like, oh, I mean, any critiques that I have are very minor. It totally threw me right back in Middle Earth, and it was a good send-off and farewell movie. I mean, totally enjoyed the whole Lord of the Rings experience, starting from when they started with Fellowship and this final movie, just excellent. And if they happen to get the Silmarillion, then maybe 10 years from now, I would not mind to see what they would think. You know, if it would be Peter Jackson or someone else led under Peter Jackson, it'd be cool to see what they would come up with that, because there's a lot of backstory behind that. But anyway, that is another discussion for later. So critiques. Let us talk about critiques a second. There was a moment in a Legolas fight scene. It's around close to the end of the movie, where Legolas is fighting this big orc. And there comes a moment when, and like I said, this is a spoiler, so If you haven't seen it, go watch it. But he's like, there are stones falling from this path they're fighting on, falling into a chasm, and he's leaping from stone to stone that's like falling in midair. And I'm just like, okay, you kind of pushed it a little bit there. That's a little bit unrealistic, even for Legolas. So, like I said, that's only a minor thing that only happened for me once, and then, you know, they continue with the fight scene, and okay, that's fine. I've heard complaints that there wasn't much character development in this movie, and there wasn't as much as in your usual movie, but you had the last two movies to basically uplift those characters. And really, it's a battle of five armies. How much character development can you have when you have just basically a build-up to a huge battle? So I like how they worked in the character development for Thorin, though, how he goes kind of dark and then back, how it shows in the book. I love how he is able to redeem himself. And one other thing, I think the eagles should have been, like, they show the eagles swooping in the last second to save the day, but kind of. And they don't show enough of the eagles, personally, I think. I think they should have, you know, had more scenes with the eagles in there. They only show them as basically the cavalry in the last 5 seconds of the battle, and then that's it. So, but like I said, time constraints, I'm sure in the extended version you're going to see more of that. So, for me, small critiques, but that's basically how I feel. But like I said, overall, awesome movie. I think is my movie of the year, for sure. Loved it. So, thank you, Peter Jackson, for all you did for these movies. I can't wait to get, I mean, I have a Lord of the Rings trilogy extended edition. I can't wait to get the extended edition for these movies as well. So that was a wonderful birthday gift for this year. And now let's move on to the Star Wars trailer, which wasn't really a full trailer, just a teaser. So you just had a few scenes. You had some voiceover in the background, some dark character. But so far, I love the tone of the movie. I think my two favorite scenes was, one, the stormtrooper scene, where you see those shots of the stormtrooper, very gritty shots of these stormtroopers coming out. That was one of my most favorite scenes to see in that trailer, as well as the Millennium Falcon flying in the air and swooping, just an angle you've never seen it fly before. Just like, yes. Oh, yes. It was a great teaser. And I look forward to see what J.J. Abrams have to do. I love what he's planning to do with at least the tone of the movie. So let's just now see what the storyline is going to be like in the future, you know, in the coming months into next year, into next December when the movie comes out. We'll see what happens. I look forward to see what J.J. Abrams have to do. And more than likely, he will do a great job no matter what we think. Even if we don't like the storyline, I'm sure he will make a great movie. At least that's what it looks like so far. So I look forward to that for next year. And that's basically my review and my thoughts on some movies. And that's all I have for you. So I will see all of you next week. And the whole time I've been doing this with a pen, you've probably been hearing pop, 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 pop. Oh well. Later.